Hello everyone, this is Sumita Gupta. Today I'll explain you how to perform experiment of inverting and non-inverting op-amp using virtual laboratory. So this is the circuit diagram of inverting op-amp. In theory lecture, you can get the detailed explanation, but for now you can understand output is 180 degree out of phase with the input. If input is, suppose this, then output will be 180 degree out of phase with the input. So output will be like this. If input is in this form, then output will be just opposite of the input. Okay, so that is your inverting op-amp. And if you will see, the input is applied at the inverting terminal, at negative. Input is applied at the inverted terminal is at negative. For non-inverting, the input will be applied at the positive terminal. Okay, so now what is the output? If you see, I'm giving you a brief introduction due to the concept of virtual ground and virtual short. If zero voltage is here, same zero voltage will be here. Okay. Now, suppose current is flowing in this path is I1 and current in flowing in the feedback part is I2. Now, if you apply KCL at this node, then you will see current I1 equals to current I2. What is current I1? Current I1 will be V in minus, this is zero voltage, V in minus zero by R in. V in minus zero by R in. If you will check the output current is flowing from this node to output node. It will be 0 minus V naught divided by RF. If you solve this equation, then what you will get? V naught equals to minus RF by R in into V in. Now see, if V in is positive, then you are getting the negative output. If V in is positive, you will get the negative output. So output is input multiplied by this term. This term is called as gain. This term is called as a gain. Okay. So now you understand how why it's called inverting, because you are applying positive, but you are getting negative output. Or in terms of waveform, if you are giving sine wave, you will get the output waveform 180 degree out of phase with input. Okay. So this is a gain of inverting. Next, for non-inverting op-amp, the same circuit you can take, but remember now, in negative terminal it is grounded, but input is connected at the positive terminal. Or you can see here, if you see this diagram, next what you can do, just make it ground, cross it and connect V in here, connect V in here, then it will called as non-inverting op-amp. If you make it ground and connect V in as positive terminal, then it will called as non-inverting op-amp. Okay. For non-inverting op-amp, the expression will be gain equals to 1 plus RF by RIN. Or you can say, if you are say giving this input, then you will get the same output. So there is no inverting. Non-inverting is no inversion. So output will be in the form, same form with the input. Okay. Or you can say the gain is positive. Okay. So detail you can find in lecture. So I will explain now with the virtual lab. Okay. Now in virtual lab, just press VLab, virtual lab. In virtual lab, click on electronics and communication. In electronics and communication, come down and click on basic electronics lab. In basic electronics lab, click on list of experiments. In list of experiments, come down, scroll down and take study of basic properties of operational amplifier inverting and non-inverting op-amp. So here, first theory is given. You can learn yourself theory. Okay. Next procedure is given. What we have to do? How the connection will be done? Okay. Now, next is simulation. In simulation, first we will do inverting op-amp. Now see. What we have to do, first we are doing for inverting op-amp, so connect this resistance at input side, connect feedback resistance, feedback to output, connect in non-inverting terminal to ground and inverting terminal to input voltage. Okay, after doing this, you can check connection. Now it is saying it's the right connection. Now set R1 and RF. This is R1 and this is RF. So set, I'm selecting R1 is suppose 1K. Okay, and RF is 10K suppose. Or you can take any value, right? Okay, now add to table. And keep resistance value constant and vary this input. Suppose input is 1 volt. What should be the output? Suppose I am taking input is 1 volt. What should be the output? Output voltage should be, as per this PPT, if you can understood, in inverting op amp, Vout equals to RF into Rin into Vin. So RF we have taken 10 and Rin we have taken 1, to 10 by 1 is 10. And inverting output is in negative form. So output will be minus 10. Output will be minus 10. Okay. So in this way, you can vary the inputs and you can, will have the different values of the output. And what is your task? Just verify whether you are getting the same output or not. Because output will be input multiply by RF by Rin. Input, whatever input multiply by RF by Rin is 10. 10 by 1 is 10. So whatever input output is 10 multiply by input. But if input is positive, the output will be negative. See here, if input is positive, output negative. Input is negative, output positive. 1 multiply by 10, 10. 8 multiply by 10, 80. 3 multiply by 10, 30. 5 multiply by 10, 50. Okay. Or you can check the V0 by VI plot. Since it's an inverting amplifier, so it will be negative. Okay. So this is for inverting op amp. Same you can check for non-inverting op amp. For non-inverting op amp, remember the input is connected to non-inverting terminal. And inverting terminal will be connected to ground. Okay. So in this way, we'll do the connections and now check connection. Again, set this R. Now in the non-inverting op amp, remember the output is 1 plus RF by Rin. Okay. So I am taking, suppose RF is 9. RF I'm taking 9. For simplicity only, you can take any value. 9. And R1 I'm taking 1. Okay. Okay. Now you can vary the input. Now what is the output? Output is 1 plus RF by Rin. RF is 9 and Rin 1. 1 plus 9 is 10. So output will be input multiplied by 10. But plus is plus, minus plus. So see, input is minus 15. So output is minus 50 multiplied by 10, minus 150. Input is minus 12. Output is minus 12 multiplied by 10 is minus 120. So if you are giving minus, you will get minus. If you will give positive, you will get the positive. Okay. So what is your task? Verify this. Okay. Just take any values here randomly and check whether you are getting the same voltage or not. And you can plot. Now plot is in form increasing because it's a non-inverting op amp. Non-inverting op amp means you're not inverting anything. If input is 10, then output is 100. So output is increasing. That's why plot is like this. Okay. So thank you so much. Keep learning. Keep sharing. God bless you.